We are at the F-Cell Wall Drive and switching to English. I have one expert here with me standing in front of this big truck. May I ask you to introduce you? What is your name and what is your job?
Okay, my name is John Homer. I'm a senior customer engineering technician. I'm here on this tour for a short period of time. Excuse me. Just mainly a support for the tank truck here, and just to make sure safety's in place, grounding. We have nitrogen for purging and such. That basically a support role.
Your part is only in America, or?
I'm only on the tour for actually three stops. Last night in Florida, today in Grand Bay here, and Stennis Space Center, and then we'll turn it over to another technician over in Louisiana.
And what's your experience with this F-Cell Wall Drive? Do you like it? Is it interesting for you? Is it just a job? Is it as usual?
It's very interesting. I mean, it's a lot of technology I didn't know about before. You know, and I've been dealing with industrial and medical gases for 30 years. So it's very interesting. Mm-hmm. And a wonderful group of people to work with.
Yes, it's a nice team. And what is important, what is interesting for the people who are looking this video, what can you tell us? What is important? The security, it's not so usual to drive with such a lot of gas, hydrogen around.
It's contained, it is safe. Everything is DOT approved, which is Department of Transportation. Everything is inspected, and everything is up to par on everything, or else we cannot move the equipment. It's something, you say hydrogen, everybody thinks of the Hindenburg. It's not like that. It's all self-contained, and it's very safe.
Mm-hmm. And what do you expect in America? There are not so many hydrogen stations. What do you expect? What is the development? What's the trend in America?
I think right now is the trend is if the price of oil keeps going up, where fossil fuels, gasoline, diesel fuel get so expensive that they're going to have to find another alternative, and this is the right path to go down.
And do you think that the technique of the B class of F cells must be for a longer distance, right?
Not really. Probably 70% of the people in the United States drive as local. It's not long distance driving, except for, large vehicles and everything. But just normal everyday travel, I think it's a great alternative to fossil fuels.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I think we have little time only. I could talk very, very long to you. I would like to say thanks for having me here to the questions that I can ask to you. Thanks for your answers, and we make it short. Thank you very much, John.
Okay, thank you, and enjoy yourself in America.